Today, I will show you how to install Jellyfin in a Docker container. This container will also start with your server when you reboot it. First, log into an account with sudo privileges. If you don't have Docker on your server, download the install script. With curl-fs, capital SL, https://get.docker.com-o/get-docker.sh. Then run it with sudo sh get-docker.sh. After installing, make sure it works with docker run hello-world. Next, make a user to run Docker with. Sudo user add -m capital G docker comma underscore ssh docker user. I'm adding ssh since I'm connecting over it. Set the password with sudo passwd docker user. On the root of your shared folder, make a folder for Jellyfin. Inside that folder, make a folder for TV shows and one for movies. Log out and then log back in using the Docker account. Now we will make the script for the container. Nano jellyfin-container.sh. First we will do docker run -d / --- name equals jellyfin-server / -e tz equals, and then your time zone code. I will put a link to the list of time zone codes in the description. Put in your time zone and then do / -e PUID equals 1000 / and -e PGID equals 1000 / These two set the permissions for your Docker container. -p 8096 :8096 / This is the port that Jellyfin uses. -v, and now we need a path to your shared folder. Go to your shared folders in your admin panel and copy the absolute path. Paste in the path and then follow it with / jellyfin / tv. Then do : / data / shows, or whatever you want it to be called. Everything after the colon is what the Docker container will see the path as. Do a / and then another -v, paste the path again, and do / jellyfin, and this time do movies, :// data / movies, / --- restart unless --stopped / ghcr.io / linux server / jellyfin. Exit out with control X, Y, enter. Run the script with sh jellyfin-container.sh. When you run the script, it will take some time to download the image. After it has finished running, open a web browser and enter your IP address followed by the port 8096. And follow the setup instructions. Set your username and password. Here, you will add your media libraries. First, let's do shows. Click on the path for shows. The rest of the settings are just preferences, such as region settings for metadata. After that, do the same for your movie folder. Choose your metadata language. And if you want remote access, I don't. Log in with your credentials. And, as you can see, Jellyfin has already scanned my media library, complete with images and metadata. If a movie or show does not get recognized, you can manually press Identify and choose what the title is. Since your Jellyfin folder is in your network share, adding new movies is as easy as drag and dropping them in. When you add new media to your folders, go to the admin dashboard and click Scan All Libraries. Thank you for watching.